My students have done a really great job of giving me feedback on all of these videos, and one common suggestion is that I stop talking. So obviously for this video, I will be speaking as much as possible. Okay, but really this video is not actually a tutorial. It's just a time-lapse video, but I did watch it and try to reflect on some of the problems that I encountered so that I can better prepare you on how to resolve them yourself. So make sure you watch the whole video because I do periodically give feedback. Also, sometimes just by watching a process, you can gain a better understanding of how it's done. So if colored pencils aren't your thing, try to follow along and maybe you'll pick up on something that you find helpful. For my first tip, I want to remind everyone to build values using layers. I commonly see my students treating their artwork as if it's a coloring book, and they just put heavy outlines in their objects and then fill them in with solid color. But you will never achieve realism that way. Notice how I'm treating this cloth. I start with my local color, I gradually push back my darks, then bring up my highlights and transitional tones, and it is all accomplished using very thin layers of color. For my next tip, I would say start with highlights. You can see here that I start with the highlight, which is something that I don't commonly do. Typically, I'll try to burnish over the top of my colors to create highlights at the end, but I noticed that I wasn't able to get the highlights on my pumpkin as bright as I wanted to because it was just too dark. So if you're using a toned paper, try starting by lightly putting down some of your highlight color in your highlight areas, just as a way of letting you know that you shouldn't build up too much color in those spots. Thanks. third tip is to mix it up. So drawing cloth is a nightmare shared among all artists, I think. And to make matters worse, here I've chosen a gold cloth with a reflective surface, so it's even more obnoxious. Also, on a personal level, I just don't like drawing plants. I think flowers and trees and bushes, they just all have too much detail. So since both of these things are in my composition, you can see that I jump back and forth between them. They just require a lot of attention, so to avoid getting too frustrated or bored with the piece, I only spend a little time with each section. I would encourage you to do the same thing if you find yourself rushing to finish a portion of your work just to get it done. This last tip might be the most important, which is, look at what you're drawing. Here I took some artistic liberty and changed the color of the roses in the cow skull. They're orange in my reference, and I made this choice because I just don't like the way that they look. But the important thing to notice is that I am still using my photo reference to understand where the values are. This is a huge issue I've seen in class. You must look at your photo reference. Always. If you notice, I not only have my gridded reference next to me at all times, but I'm also using the original photo on my phone to zoom in and get some of the finer details. The bottom line is that every experienced artist drawing from observation will look at the thing they are drawing as often, if not more often, that they are looking at their actual drawing. And that's it, guys. I hope you found this video helpful. Remember to like and subscribe.